in terms of agribusiness, here we are also showing farmers that you can utilize a small piece of land to maximize profit, provided you follow all the best management practices. Now, in this small demonstration, we have only 80 stems of plants. It was supposed to be 90, but some of them died due to some other factors. But now, out of this 80 plants, we have only a small piece of land, which is measuring 6.5 meters by 8 meters. And we have three ridges only. Each ridge is having three lines of eggplant. One ridge like this one is having three lines. 1, 2, 3. So in the eggplant here, it is having three lines which has been planted in zigzag pattern to avoid overcrowding. But you can see the plant is very bushy because of the factors that we have done to it. The height of the plant is now between 130 to 140. The height of the plant is between 130 to 140 centimeters. That is the height of the plant. Now, in this one, the average fruits that is being harvested per one harvest is between 5 to 6 fruits per plant, because you don't harvest all. This one is per harvest, and we have already harvested 3 quality times. So the average fruits already harvested within 7 weeks per plant is between 14 to 17. So this is what I was meaning. Now, when you look at quality fruits, which is already matured, you'll find that only one mature fruit, which is very nice and delicious, is between 25 to 30 centimeters. That is when you leave it for 10 days and more. Let's say you can leave it for 13 days and then you come and harvest. You'll find the fruit is now well matured. Because most of the farmers, they tend to harvest the small fruits. You harvest the small fruits, yet you can leave this fruit because it is a hand hybrid. You can see it is even very soft. It's not like the local variety when the fruit has reached this size. You'll find now it becomes bitter. This one is sweet, very nice and delicious. I want farmers to give time for quality production to occur, because if you don't do like that, you will be losing money. But if you harvest small fruits like this, you have to put many. You have to put very many. Let us not rush for the little money with the low quality fruits. It's better we take our time, we carry out all the agronomic practices, the best management practices, and come out with a very high potential yield, so that you can harvest enough or adequate amount of money. Let's say one stem of plant, we are picking 6 quality fruits, and we have 80 stems of fruits in this demo, which that is giving us to around 440, like that, or 420 fruits that we are going to whatever. If you divide by 3, we are going to put like 3 here for 500. This is in the village, but in town you can hit like 1000 because of the quality. So if you are selling 133 bunches, if you multiply by 500 shillings, you'll get like 60,000 per harvest in this small demonstration. And now this plant is liable to be harvested for 1 year and above, simply because of the good practice that we had. Like last week, we added, we just top dressed with the plant tea. Plant tea, which was mixed with the organic liquid manure, we added. And that's why you can see the quality of the fruit is coming very fast. So if you are only feeding the plant very well, you carry out potential harvest in time, and then you reduce the duration for harvest. If you used to harvest after 10 days, you'll find within 7 to 8 days, you are already harvesting the high quality, because you are feeding the plant and then you are watering the plant. So agribusiness does not need laziness. And I'm advising farmers to deviate from these other local varieties. The variety which is not tolerant to soil-borne factors or diseases, you have to desist from it, so that you come for hybrid. Like this is Femi F1. Now, Femi F1 with this Femi F1, eh, you buy 5 grams at 50,000 Uganda shilling, or which a farmer may think it is very, very expensive, because 5 grams it is having accountable seeds. This one you spend 50,000, and now today we are harvesting 50,000 in one day, and you are going to harvest for 1 year. How much money do you think you are going to get in a year?
What I've seen, the fruits which are down like this are here, when the crops are just a bush like this, the fruits down here, they tend to grow very big, as you see here. They can grow very big because when they are down here, they are not over exposed to the sunlight, which may make its texture to be hard for human consumption. But when it is down like this in a bush place, it tends to be so palatable to human consumption, as you see here. Mm. So it is also good to leave them in a bush place like the way we have done ours here.
So what you are saying is the spacing must be considered?
If you overspace them, of course the fruits, all of them, they will be exposed to sunlight, so the texture will be hard for human consumption. But when it is not so spaced like here, so that it will provide some bush place, area, as you see, so the consumption will be so.
Now, this morning, I am going to carry an harvest of the eggplant. Eh? When you look at this, they are now ready for harvest. Eh? So just take a look at the production, the potential yield from here. Eh? Now, I was explaining to you about the maturity of the eggplant. When you look at this eggplant here, they are now matured and ready for consumption, for human consumption. But if you to grow into a full maturity, which is not old but full maturity, you end up getting more profit than harvesting them when they are not yet fully matured. Eh? Now today, I am going to pick maximally 5 fruits per plant. Look at this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, even 6. So, and then I leave the rest. Like this one is not yet has not yet attained full maturity. Even this one has not yet attained full maturity. Eh? Because I need profit, I need to give them time, like 10 days before harvesting it. So you will, when you leave it for 10 days, at least now you will pick 5 fruits per plant. 5. Or 4 or something like 6. Eh? Then this one, look at this one. 1 is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Eh? This plant alone will give me 7. Eh? So there is business in it. You see? There is business in farming, provided you are serious and investing in it. So you need not to invest in something cheap. You have to buy a quality seeds, the hybrids, and then you need to know the best management practices in raising this kind of vegetables. You avoid causing injuries to the plant. Eh? That is why you are supposed to cut. You use a sharp knife or a pair of scissors to cut. Like this. So, and you remember to select only the mature one. The one which has attained full maturity is the one you should pick. If you see it is not of quality, is not yet very big, please don't waste money. Because when you pick a mature one, you will be losing money. You have to put very many of them. Like 6 for 500 shillings. farming is very interesting.
The knife is not sharp. You need to use a sharp knife to avoid damaging the plants.
Farmers make some mistakes which affects further production. If it is time for harvest, you find a lazy farmer will come and just start plucking. You find that like this, causing a lot of, is not a good thing. Look here. If you just pluck, if you just pluck like this, first look at how, what damage you have caused here. Yet, still, you need this upper part. You can see the upper part is still flowering and the young fruit is coming. But during the time of plucking it, you will create a big wound, and now here can even break. You can see here it has entered deep. See? You see the kind of damage which you have caused. So you can cause a damage if you just pluck. That is why it is advisable for farmers to avoid this kind of laziness or practices of pulling it, just pulling it like this. Not knowing that you are creating a lot of wounds on the plant. Sometimes even the young part or the young branch can break, yet you still expect 4 or 5.
With this kind of potential yields, like the quality of the fruits here, you expect the plant to be a heavy feeder now. You can now see the plant is already exhibiting signs of nutrient deficiency. When you look at the leaves, even from the younger parts of the leaves are now yellowing, especially beginning from the leaf margin. So it's an indication that the plant is now feeding heavily because it is producing a lot of fruits, of which we need now to feed the plant. We need to support the plant by adding more nutrients so that we continue to pick such kind of fruits.
Okay, my name is Mr. Donemi. I'm so amazed and so grateful to come out with this such a potential harvest that I've got from this. And I'm so happy also to from the knowledge I got from C&D to come out with this kind of potential harvest. So I'm so hopeful that if I go back to my village, I will also train some other farmers to do the same thing like what I've now got today. So with this, my thanks go to the C&D. I'll let us just be so grateful.
So like this one, how much do you expect to get?
Expect something which is more than 50,000.
We are trying to pack them in the sack. It's there.
Let's hope we are going to benefit some, we are going to get some good amount.
So now, like this one, how much are we going to sell?
3 for 500.
You put like 2 big ones and then 1 medium one, for 500. This one is in the village, isn't it?
Yes.
But in the town, how much can it cost?
1,000.
Between 700 to 1,000. But now, let us also determine. We need to check how many fruits give us 1 kilogram, so that we know how many in terms, if you are selling in terms of kilograms. How do you determine the cost? Yes, Vanessa. How many fruits is that? Has it reached a kilo?
1 kilogram,
not enough. But you get a small one. But yeah, it's 1 kilo. Oh. 3 big ones and then 1 small one. First, put that one. see that? Exactly 1 kilo. Huh? Grading, eh? Grading. When you're, don't just put all the big one and you remain with the small one. You have to balance it. Balancing the big one and then the small one. Yeah. You can see this one now, they are only small. Yeah, this you exchange. That one, big one. So let us determine our potential harvest. How much money are we going to get from today's harvest? Come and display. Put in the sacks. Yeah. The cover pot one. It will be more than that. How many have you added?
A farmer who is not patient cannot wait for fruits to be very mature. So the one who is patient can harvest the fruits which are mature, whereby you can even sell at 500 three of them for 1,000. And the one who is not patient can put 8 like this one, all of them here, 8 at 1,000 only. But the one who is patient can put only 3 at 1,000, like the way you're seeing there, whereby the one who is patient will get high income than the one who is not patient, like this one. This one will make losses.
So why do you say he can make loss?
He can make losses because he'll be putting like 8 of them small, and at sometimes some customers will refuse and he will make like 10 for 1,000. But the one who will come and find it when it is big like that, someone will be attracted and you will pay that 1,000 at 3 fruits, whereby that farmer is going to earn more income than the one who is not patient.
I advise farmers always to be very patient and wait for the plants to mature, like of this size, which they can get good quality. Other than just being impatient, you can just sell your products at a loss.
Farming is a source of income. And when you go back, if you have not yet chance getting a job, please, you now see how people can make money, in a very small piece of land. And this is called agribusiness. You're growing crops in a small piece of land, and then you are making profit out of it. I get that. So I don't want to relax. And when you chance to get a job, make sure you also follow what we are doing, by giving a good technical advice to your farmers so that they can also be able to make money, okay? So I wouldn't wish to see you loitering around looking for job, but go and create your own job. Is it clear?
Check the kilo. Turn it this way. Turn it this way. I see. So it is 36. 36 plus the other one, which is 11. 11 plus 36? 47 kilograms that we have harvested.
Division of labor. Your team is in a chair. Maybe department will not get ready. Purchase your tracks today.
now in under post-harvest handling, whereby we want to even add some values to this eggplant. It is now dried, and the moisture content is no longer in such a way that it can affect. So, if you can dry it very well, clean and very and well dried like this, you can keep it and wait for the time of scarcity, such that you can fetch a better income. You can earn profit from this kind of production. Let us not be farmers who rush. When you rush, you can earn very little. But if you are patient enough, a farmer who is very patient in terms of the production, fetch a higher income compared to the one who is not patient.
This is what we call post-harvest handling. So during the period of bump harvest, whereby there are very many eggplants on the market, when you want to fetch a good market, a good income of your eggplant, this is how you can add value. You chop them into smaller pieces, then you sun dry. After sun drying, you pack. These eggplants can take a good period of time. And even when you are selling, this cup here, one of it is at 1,500.
Or 2,000.
Or 2,000, or even 3,000, depending on the scarcity and the period. Because there are certain periods when the source is not available. Here we are now weighing the dried eggplants, and of which we have gotten 3 kilograms, which is equivalent to 49 cups, the nice cup. So when it was still wet, we got 47 kilograms. So you can see the difference, 47 and 3. Then when you go to the market, 47,000, 47 kilograms, you get around 47,000 when you are selling 3 big ones at 1,000. Whereas here, we have gotten 3 kilograms. But when we are selling using the cup, we are going to sell one cup at 1,500 or even 3,000, depending on the scarcity of the source. So when you multiply 1,500 times 49 kilograms, you come up with 73,500. And when you check on the difference, at least when you go for this, will be when you have added value to your farming. That's why people leave farming thinking that there is no money. But once you do value addition, you can earn better than one who is waiting monthly salary.
Mm.
I advise fellow farmers to always carry out value addition. Yeah, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. To add on to that, also, you know, like most of the farmers in our region here depends on rain-fed agriculture, whereby during rainy season, everybody go for a particular kind of crop. You find now last year eggplant was raising well, then this year everybody goes for farming. We want to address this issue by advising you as farmers to adopt a complete value chain of agribusiness. You grow crops, you add values to it. Like that now, this one, if we are to pack into sachets and label it, it will go at maybe like 1 cup or 2 cups for 5,000. And if you are supplying to supermarkets, are you seeing that? So there is hope in farming, provided you know what you're doing and then you are committed to follow all the procedures and the best managed practices, right from production to post-harvest handling and value addition. So thank you so much, Joshua, for all this research that we have done. Now we know that there is profit when you add values to your product. But when you sell it raw or fresh, you get little, of which is a very good thing that we have done. Thank you so much. So dear viewers, subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you don't miss any posts. Thank you.